This project is called Zoetropes in After Effects, although technically they're phenakistoscopes. And its aim is to explore frame rates and some of the oldest forms of animation and how they tricked your eye into perceiving a movement that wasn't really there. It's the kind of project that can expand or contract depending on how much time you've got. So you could use it for a single lesson or multiple lessons and bring it out over the course of a week if you really wanted to. It's designed for any age group, from late primary school up to university level. I really like this lesson because it's a way to look at some of the concepts and history of film in a way that's really practical and hands-on. It's a great way to get students started in thinking about frame rates and the mathematics behind making film. So the primary design principle looked at in this project is movement, but there are a range of other ones that can be integrated into it quite easily because it looks at change. And this can be change in elements or change in subject matter. So you can use it to make a stick figure animation man walking along, but you could also use it for change in elements, warm colours through to cool colours, or shapes moving from geometric to organic. So the main thing to make sure that you've got when you're teaching this is access to resources. So you should have heaps and heaps of printouts, as well as access to a scanner and access to a computer. Some students will be really focused on drawing one thing really well, while others will want to make multiple versions and then keep testing and trialing and seeing how it works. My top tip for making this work is to ask heaps of questions. I'll try to embed a bunch of them inside the sheet, asking how this works, how your eye works this way, but asking questions is really important.